Hi, Mark here from the Tangent Bound Podcast Network and host of the flagship show, the Tangent Bound Podcast. Did you know that we over at Tangent Bound are always looking for amazing podcasts to promote? And did you also know that we are also proud nerds and geeks of everything from movies, music, gaming, TV shows, and comic books to wrestling, MMA, soccer, and football? Whatever you can nerd or geek out about, we've got it. And if you're interested, we can help you find it. And if you're a show looking for a place to call home, we've got you covered. Side effects may include upset stomach, dizziness, tumors, shakes, and in some rare cases, death from excessive laughter. Though to be fair, it's only sometimes. Other side effects may include diarrhea, gallstones, heart palpitations, and strong desire for cookies on the dark side. Talk to your doctor and visit TangentBoundNetwork.com and see if Tangentbound Network is right for you.
This is a Danger Entertainment podcast. DangerEntertainment.net. Danger Entertainment Podcast Network.
Welcome to the podcast from Temperance Town. The sexiest podcast of world renowned. Tony grows a beard to hide his chin, swaps it with Earl so it glistens.
Salty, salty language, kings of the sexy frontier.
Download the pod, you won't get enough of these dapper chaps talking deadly fluff. In Hobo Gulch, they run a homeless mission, clanging and banging with a pentagram of kittens.
Salty, salty language, kings of the sexy frontier.
They enjoy their whiskey and local craft beer. By Odin's unkempt pubis, we give a cheer. Tony's a raccoon when he's booziest. Don't be a savage, be an enthusiast.
Salty, salty language, kings of the sexy frontier.
On the frozen tundra, they call it a lock. Tony likes to masturbate in a sock. Brian pisses rocks cause it feels so great. I still don't know who the fuck is Tate.
Salty, salty language, kings of the sexy frontier.
The boys will let you know when there's a
spurler.
Due to male pattern baldness, they don't wear curlers. Stay salty, people, that's their closing line. And don't forget, have a beer, you'll be fine.
Salty, salty language, kings of the sexy frontier. Salty, salty language, kings of the sexy frontier.
Hey enthusiasts, what's happening? This is Salty Language, episode 379.
Sexiest podcast still running. Bitches.
All right, so last week we came at him with 30% strength. What are we hitting this week?
I don't know, man.
Are you above 30?
I think I'm above 30, but okay. I'm all out of whack and disoriented.
Okay, so probably 40.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
I'm all fucked up.
That's fair.
You know?
Right.
And leave group. By Bedford Township bullshit.
Damn.
Sorry, I'm conducting personal business on the show.
Yeah, very much so. Now all of our Bedford local people who started listening because of that group are going to leave.
I know that whole chapter of Facebook just felt like a wave of coldness washed through them as I left the group.
No, that's just Facebook in general, my friend.
Oh, you're right.
Yeah,
you're right. That's just hot garbage.
Ding, you are correct, sir. Yeah. Yep.
Hey, Brian, how's it going, mate?
Hey, you know, it's what it is. It's November.
Dude, this day of the dead.
Right?
It's about to party.
Yeah.
I guess. Let's get some skeletons going.
I know, right? Luckily,
too much.
We can finally quit shaving.
Oh, God. That is just a dumb. And I know we talk about this every
I know. Year. That's why I brought it up, because we do it every year. Yeah.
Oh, no, sir. I'm going to clean shave my beard and then not shave.
Right.
Yeah. I got an idea. Go fuck yourself.
So I just realized something.
What's up, sir?
We did not start the show with Werewolf Bar Mitzvah.
Well, we can just do it right now.
Okay, let's do that.
All right. So, take two.
My key to the city of Gary, Indiana. Look at this. My gold record from that novelty party song.
Aw, man, Trey, look up at the sky. It's a full moon on the Sabbath.
This is scary.
Break it down.
I was working late on my half Torah when I heard a knock on my bedroom door. I opened it up, and to my surprise, there was a werewolf standing there with glowing gold eyes. He said, tomorrow, my son, you will be a man. But tonight's the time to join the wolfing clan. Tomorrow you will stand at the beamer and pray. But tonight, let's gaze at the moon and bathe. Werewolf for mitzvah, spooky, scary. Boys becoming men, men becoming wolves. Werewolf for mitzvah, spooky, scary. Boys becoming men, men becoming wolves.
All right, that was great. Okay.
I mean, it is tradition.
It is. I meant for us to do that last week. But I forgot. So we're doing like The Simpsons, how a lot of times the Treehouse of Horror is on like November 6th or something. Right. You know, so we're just a couple days past Halloween.
Just gonna let it play in the background for us.
Fair enough.
You know, because tradition.
Wow. That works well.
I know, right?
Yeah.
Oh, man. Yeah, it was Halloween time.
Yeah. Did you do anything?
You know, I went up with, it was Leah's last year. She dressed up as Stitch in a Stitch onesie, and I think she's worn it every day since.
Right.
And, I hung up them and, the Risk and the Jisk, and, you know, we had a couple beers, had some pizza, walked around the neighborhood, you know?
Yeah.
Got some candy for the girl and then ended up taking about half of it to my work.
Oh, yeah.
Braces.
Right.
They gave her so much shit that she couldn't eat.
Yeah, that's unfortunate. You know, it's funny. I saw a whole bunch of stuff in the week leading up to it where people were talking about, you know, if people could to try to be more mindful of, you know, kids with allergies to maybe have some treat that they could have too, you know, and also to maybe also, you know, try to be aware of like kids with autism. You know, which is great. It's, you know, because you want everybody to be, you know, to get their candies and whatnot.
Well, naturally.
But it's like these poor kids with braces. It's like no one gives a shit about them.
Well, it's funny because the Risk and the Jisk had two buckets.
Yeah.
They had the candy bucket and then they had the allergy bucket.
Well, so they just had random allergies in the bucket? That sounds terrible.
Like, what do you have? Peanut allergy? Here's a Reese's.
Oh, geez. That's awful.
No, it was like stickers and shit and stuff,
okay.
You know. Yeah, but and I think they handed out one.
Yeah,
but I mean, it's cool they participated in the like allergy zone or whatever.
Yeah, well, it is tough because you know the main allergy generally is peanut butter, you know.
Yes.
But there are, you know, obviously a variety of other allergies, you know, various dairy products and what have you. So. You know, it's tough to, you can't have something for everybody generally, unless you're like, you just can't have something for everybody because everyone's allergic to something, you know? Like, I can only eat so much strawberry stuff, you know?
Right.
I can have strawberries, but I can only eat a little amount. If I eat more than that, I start getting hives, you know?
Yeah. So dude, I hear you. I can only drink so much.
Yeah.
It's fucking over.
Right. Then it becomes a mess. Yeah.
Yeah. No, it's, I don't know. I mean, I'm one of those lucky people that if I have an allergy, I really don't know what it is
because
it doesn't really affect me that much if I have one.
Yeah.
And, I don't know. I've just never had to deal with that shit and I'm a big fan.
Yeah. I'd really like to go in and have one of those allergy test ones, you know, where they like, pinprick your, what is it, your arm or your back like 1,000 times or whatever.
Yeah, with like every known allergen.
Yeah, and then they're like, oh, you're allergic to like gray cats with white beards. And
right, exactly.
Like it Black was a
magic.
Well, my brother had one done, and it was weird how like it gets fairly detailed on, you know, because I mean, within the allergen, you know, situation, it broke it down pretty well for him. So I was like, it seems like that could be really helpful to like, hey, I'm allergic to this. Now I can avoid it. You know, like
right
now I know if I go outside, my allergies kick up, but I don't know exactly what I'm allergic to. I'm just allergic to something out there, you know,
could be the outdoors.
Yeah, it probably is. It's like, get closer to the Wi-Fi. Yeah.
Right. Exactly. You wandered away from the Wi-Fi.
Right.
That's your problem, Brian.
Yep. You're right. But yeah, I don't think if I went into my doctors and was like, hey, can I have this done? I'm not sure that they would do it without a, you know, reason.
Right. So just cause I wanna.
Yeah. Just cause I wanna. Yeah.
Like we found out you're allergic to licorice, but not Twizzlers, red vines.
Yeah.
Like, what? That's not even real licorice. We know.
Oh man. Don't start that debate, dude. Let's not do that. Man, I don't want to divide the internet.
I know, right?
It's already bad enough with the pineapple thing on pizza.
Yep, fair enough.
Which is just blasphemy. But yeah, I don't know if my insurance would pay for it unless it was, you know, like if I ended up at a dermatologist or some allergy specialist and then they asked for it, then my insurance might pay for it. Because I've noticed that, like any real testing, my insurance doesn't seem to like to pay for it until I get to a specialist. You know, it's like I have to go to my family physician, then a specialist, then, okay, all right, well, you've gotten a second opinion, so I guess we'll pay for a test.
Fine.
Yeah.
I guess.
Like, in order to pay for my, the testosterone blood work that I had done, I had to have it done twice because they had to have a number twice that was low. Otherwise, they basically wouldn't pay for anything going forward. You know?
Well, that's interesting.
Yeah, right? It's like, yeah. Okay.
Thanks, buddy.
Like, well, I hope I don't get a big spike in testosterone before the second test.
Yeah, really, right? Stay away from that squat rack.
Like I could. keep my firm buttocks the way they are.
I know, right?
Oh man, yeah.
Bear trap like cheeks,
right? That's right. Crushing That's right. cans in them just for fun.
Hell's yeah.
Yeah, I mean like paint cans.
Definitely.
Yep.
And they still have like paint in them and stuff.
Right, right. I have to be careful on bar stools.
They made art.
Yeah. Yeah. That would be ridiculous.
Yeah.
Oh man. If I start twerking, it's like one of those machines at the paint store that shakes the paint up to mix it all up, you know.
Definitely. It's your inspiration.
Yeah.
They call this one the paint shaker. What?
Oh, I get it.
Oh my God. I get it.
I get it now. Like anyone, like who wants a mixed drink?
Yeah, right.
Shuka shuka shuka. Oh man.
This is like cocktail, but
exactly. Oh man. Yeah, so you're pretty lucky if you know, don't have any known allergies, you know, until you get like bitten by some like caterpillar at the park or something like that, or one just crawls on you and all of a sudden you hit, you know, become a puffer fish.
Yeah, exactly, right?
Yeah, that seems to be the way some people are. Like, they have no allergies, then all of a sudden something stupid, and all of a sudden they're like, I'm going to die. I'm like, okay, this is fun.
So now I have all the allergies.
Yeah, right?
Ugh. Yeah, you do read it.
Yeah, it's true.
You do read about weird stuff like that. Like, mm-hmm. Someone gets, like, a tick bite.
Yeah.
And then they're allergic to, like, red meat all of a sudden.
Oh, that'd be horrible.
I know, right? I don't know what I would do.
I don't know, man.
I guess I'd become the great scourge in the chicken world. Yeah. Like, oh, God, he's here.
Yeah.
Lightning.
Chicken farms just start hiring you rather than, you know, having anything else butcher the chickens.
Yep, exactly. Only half make it to the truck, though.
Right. Well, you got to have payment, you know.
Got to have payment, exactly.
What do you pay him? We pay him in chickens.
What?
Like, how many? Like, depends on how hungry he is. All I know is once he starts swinging, get out of his way. He doesn't know bird from man once he starts swinging that knife. Doesn't know bird from
man. That's funny.
Oh, man.
Ha, 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 ha. That's funny.
Oh, man. Eh.
Oh, boy.
Yeah. I didn't really do anything on Halloween either, and we didn't get a lot of kids up here because, you know, I've told you before, it's like it's up or down here, you know? You just never know, and I really think this area especially is really affected by the trunk-or-treat stuff.
Right.
I really think people in this area are taking their – because, like, there's a church right up the street, and they have one, and in the community center here in the park, there's – they do one. So I think if right. nothing else, you've got two right here, you know? So a lot of parents are probably like, oh, there's no point in walking the kid all around the place when we've got, you know, and we don't have to walk them around in, you know, crappy weather or whatever.
Right. This is true.
But
at the same time, you would think just because you have so many people that live in your little neighborhood.
Yeah. You would think
people will be double dipping, you know?
But also, if you go around the neighborhood on Halloween, there's very few lights on.
Really?
And now here's the thing. I don't know which caused which, right? I don't know if like the dwindling number of kids each year caused people to just not bother. Because really, who wants to go buy like six bags of candy and then nobody shows up? Either you get really lucky kids or, you know, you're eating a bunch of candy. Yeah. Sweet. You know, so I don't know if the lack of kids caused people to quit or if people quit and that potentially has caused a decrease.
Right.
You know, but it was like,
that's it. That is interesting.
Yeah. Like we were handing out candy and was it two houses down from us was, then I think the next one was like two or three houses down from that. It was pretty sporadic. You know, it wasn't, there weren't very many like clumps of houses. So if you were on a street, you could look down the street and go, there's only like five houses. It's not worth walking down there unless you know they're giving away full size ones, you know?
Right. Well, I mean,
then it's worth one walk down there and one walk back, you know?
Yeah. Super worth it.
Just be like, come on. Nobody else is showing up.
Right. Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Hook us up.
Hook a brother up, man.
Yeah.
Y'all got any more of them full sizes?
Right. So my mom was just giving away like, she was giving away just like handfuls of candy.
What you got to give it and put it in you.
Yeah. And I mean, it was like the Snickers, Twix, Milky Way, M&M peanut mix. So it was just full of allergens.
Perfect.
Yeah.
I have the ideal way to hand out candy.
Throw it at the street.
The two-man operation.
Okay.
Okay. So you get to knock at the door, right?
Mm-hmm.
One person opens the door.
Mm-hmm.
Now you have to have it set up so your screen door is either already open or the screen and the window are up.
Mm-hmm.
And you just already have a preloaded potato gun of candy.
That would certainly surprise people. I mean, unless there's a line, then it would only surprise the first person. But, you know.
It is kind of like a shotgun blast of candy.
Right. Actually, it might surprise more than that because there's probably going to be some splash zone from... You know, them falling backwards.
Yeah. Oh, for sure. Yeah.
Yeah. That would be fun.
Seems like the ideal situation.
Also, probably get the cops called on you, but whatever.
Probably. But, like, you know.
They should have stayed off my property.
They also have to come inside and get a face full of candy.
Yeah, you just keep the thing inside your house so they can't, you know.
Yeah, for sure.
What I do but inside my house is my own business.
It's like a candy howitzer. You could dress up as like a World War II artillery guy.
Yeah, sure.
That'd be cool.
Like I was just role playing. Not my fault. They took it seriously. For sure. Yeah.
Right?
I told them.
The guy who opens the door could scream coordinates as he opens the door.
Yeah. That That'd be funny. Or you miss with like the first one, the guy at the door is like two clicks left.
Exactly. Churns a little crank.
Yeah. Oh shit. You're adjusting for wind, you know?
Yeah, for sure. Just walking M&Ms to your target.
Yeah.
Be amazing.
Yeah. More fun than, you know, the typical way of just, you know, dropping candy into a bag or letting the kids pick one.
Yeah.
Or way more how many fun. Ever you let them pick, you know.
I mean, you should make a game out of it somehow, you know.
I got to believe that the people who do give candy out, the kids probably clean up pretty well from. Because they don't get a lot around here. So maybe not at first. So the strategy, I'm thinking, is you don't go right away. You wait half an hour, 40 minutes, then you hit the streets.
Mm.
Because then you're going to hit that point where people are like, wow, nobody's really coming around. And they just start giving out fistfuls of candy.
Yeah, just to get rid of the shit.
Yeah, because so many people are like, I don't want this in my, you know, I don't want all this candy left because they have this giant bowl of it or something, you know?
Yeah, I hear you.
Meanwhile, I'll just sit on the porch and eat it while I'm waiting. So
yeah, I don't want that shit around me either.
Yeah. Beat us.
Ugh. Yeah, it's, you know, it's like, yeah, I can go for a little Snickers. It's only a little one. Right? And like 8 pieces later, yep. You're like, what am I doing?
Yeah.
I'm a monster.
You know, I love that years ago, I remember Men's Health had like a recommendation that was like, you know, not the fun size Snickers, but, you know, like the bite size, the little tiny ones that are like an inch squared.
Right.
You know, yeah,
the little minis or whatever they call them. Yeah.
You know, they were like, keep those in your house. And whenever you have a chocolate craving, have like two, you know, and I'm like, hey, that's a great idea, you know, but it's amazing how I can't count to two when I have a chocolate craving. I can only count to like six, you know.
Yeah. My magical number is sadness.
Yeah. Pretty much. Yeah.
Right.
So yeah, I quickly was like, this is a terrible idea. I was like, the smaller the portion, the worse the idea for me. Like, I'd be better off having a whole Snickers and then going, well, I'll cut it in half, you know, right. Like even doing that because, or having fun size ones, because at least with those, I look at it and go, that's pretty, you know, I mean, they're not anymore. I was going to say that's about half a candy bar, but you know, it's less than that now, but, you know, still, I'll look at that as a bigger portion. So, in, you know, visually, I'll be like, you don't need more of those, you know?
Right.
Those little ones, like you said, it's just like, you know, a few years ago on Thanksgiving, we took like those little pumpkin pie bites.
Oh, yeah.
You know? And those went just like in 2 seconds because everyone pretty much stood there and ate them like Homer eating donuts. You know?
Yeah, for sure, because they're like, you just pop them in your mouth. And...
Yep. And you don't realize it. Now you've had 8 of them. You know?
Yeah. And yeah.
Instead of just having a small piece of pie, you know?
Right.
Or in my case, one giant piece of pie. But whatever. Yeah,
a slab.
Yeah. I cut the small piece out and give that to someone.
Yeah.
And then just take this. The rest. Yeah. So, yeah.
I hear you. Mm-hmm. I mean, I totally understand what you're saying about those little minis.
Yeah.
Because it's more like an hors d'oeuvre, and you know,
right? It's like
when that hors d'oeuvre platter comes by, I'm scraping half of it into my plate.
Right? You just like jam your hand down there and get all the toothpicks stuck in your hand, and you just pull it off.
Yeah, it looks like a grizzly pulling a salmon out of the river.
Right? Or like when a dog fights a porcupine.
Yeah, for sure.
The server's like, Jesus, you know, like. He's more animal than man.
He's got his toothpicks hanging out of your face.
Yeah. You just
God, I got taken to the vet again.
You're just eating it on toothpick and all. Oh, these are so good. Like, oh, man.
Dude, that's what I need to do.
Mm.
Is when we have some sort of fancy party.
Yeah.
Quote unquote fancy.
Right.
Just get a bunch of, like, a bag of those minis and just put toothpicks in them.
Yeah, right. Why not? I've seen people do it with, like, the little squares of cheese.
Right.
You know? So why not? Yeah.
Perfect. Like, oh, did you make these? Yeah.
I sure did. I put the toothpick in myself. Exactly.
I impaled them.
Yeah. Sweet. Oh, man. I was in Target yesterday, and, you know, Target used to throw their candy at, like, 50%, like, the day after Halloween.
Right.
And I don't know when, but they realized that they should not go right to 50%. So they're at like 30% as of yesterday here. Mm-hmm. It was amazing how much of it they still sold. You know, I think people finally are doing math on that and realizing the difference between 30% and 50% when you're taking a $5 bag of candy is not much.
No.
There's really no reason to wait a couple more days, you know?
Can I tell you how annoyed I was with Target this week, though?
Okay.
I got a text from my lovely daughter.
Mm-hmm.
She was like, "Hey, Dad, can you please pick up stuff for my school's spooky room?" Mm-hmm. I forgot to ask you earlier. I went, like, yeah, it's fine.
Mm-hmm.
So I went to Target.
Right.
This is like the day before Halloween. I'm like, stuff will be discounted.
Yeah.
Nah.
Yeah, they don't do that much anymore.
And not to mention, the stuff that they did have was like ridiculously expensive.
Sweet.
It was insane. So the next morning, I was like, all right, well, let me go to Kroger, our local grocery store, because they had stuff already discounted like a week before.
Right.
And they was like, it looked like vultures attacked them. It was very well picked over.
Right. Yeah.
So I was like, oh no, what am I, you know, I have like a glow in the dark spider web and a skeleton. This is not enough for a spooky room.
It's close enough.
So I was like, well, let me do one more thing. And I hit the old Dollar General, Brian.
See, what you should have done was get a copy of like the job futures project, like the future jobs projection.
Right.
And just, you know, put that up for the kids.
Terrify all
yeah,
of
it'll
you.
Terrify all of you. Yeah.
Now, Dollar General was the win.
Yeah.
Oh my God. They had so much stuff for Spooky Room. And I walked out of spending like $11.
Right.
With a ton of shit.
Well, yeah. I mean, you know, it's a good thing.
I know there's probably notes from like Chinese children and they're like, help us and stuff. But, you know,
those throw away.
Just hanging on the walls. Terrifying.
Yeah. Right. Yeah. Just make it part of the scene. Yeah.
Part of the scene, yeah.
Yeah.
Like glowing dark skeleton holding a spooky note.
Right. Those are real.
In a different language.
Yep.
It's probably a spell.
Probably, yeah. I like it, though. That's a good move. I like the fact that, you know, that you were like, I'm going to, well, because, you know, for those who don't know, because you don't live here, are the Target and Kroger you probably went to, I'm assuming, are the ones that are like 2 seconds from each other.
Negative, Ghost Rider. Oh. I went to Target the night before.
Oh, okay.
And then the next morning, I was like, all right. It was like D-Day, the morning of D-Day. I need the spooky stuff delivered before I went to work.
Yep.
So, yeah. Yeah. But it got all worked out and figured out and all that.
Well, that's good.
And, of course, my daughter, because she's my daughter, is good. You know that glow-in-the-dark skeleton you bought me? I'm like, yeah. She's like, do you know where it is? I have no idea, Leah. Where is it? It's in my closet. Ah! And now I could be like, here's all my skeletons in my closet.
Right.
Like, God damn it.
You just pat her on the head and go, good, I've given you a start. You'll have plenty more.
Yeah, for sure, right? I don't know. She won't have much time in, you know, to gather skeletons in the closet. She keeps showing me Fortnite dances and yelling yeet all the time.
Yeah.
Yeah, like even today, she's like, hey, Dad, you want, you know, and she's wearing her full-blown Stitch onesie.
Mm-hmm.
You want to see my Fortnite dance? And I've seen him for like 3 weeks now.
Yeah.
She's 13, guys. Mm-hmm. And I went, no. But she did it anyway.
Well, because she's 13, yeah.
Exactly.
Yeah. And your daughter.
Yeah, she's basically the female miniature version of me.
Yeah.
I'm in for a nightmare situation later.
Yeah, yeah, probably. Yeah. Especially when it comes time, you know, if you make it to the, like, nursing home years, it's going to be a terrible, terrible time.
Good. Yeah, for sure.
You know she's going to pick the place with the worst, the shakiest hand nurse for the catheters.
Oh, you know? Yeah, exactly. Old Nurse Jay Fox over there.
Yeah. Can't thread a needle.
Can't thread a needle. Exactly. Certainly can't thread this dong.
Right. Oh, my. Oh, my.
Yeah. Oh, boy.
Yeah. Yeah, it's interesting how some of the stores do that, though. How they don't put anything on sale. Like Target used to, like the day of Halloween. And I'm surprised that all the stores don't do that because seriously, I was watching Christmas commercials last night on November 1st, you know?
Yeah, it's brutal.
So, you know, it's like they pretty much just want to scrub Halloween the second it's over, you know? Right? This it's never existed. Spooky. Yeah. It's like they call the wolf. Boys. Right. Yeah, they call the wolf in and have him clean it up, you know? Like,
yeah, exactly, exactly. I made a wolf reference earlier this week. Very nice, Brian.
Nice.
Yeah.
But, yeah. It was pretty well picked over at 30%, though. So when it hits 50, they're probably going to be about empty. But there was still some good stuff left, though. I was a little surprised by that. I figured it'd mostly be like, you know, Smarties and Sweet Tarts.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah. Gingers of the candy community. Sorry, Phil.
Bunch of candy corn, you know.
Goddamn, no one wants candy corn.
Speaking of, did I tell you that I saw, like, this year, they had one of the companies bagged candy corn, but they were calling it unicorn horns?
And they're, what, different colors?
Yeah.
Mm. Same thing. I mean, I guess I could get behind it a little bit because it's different, but I'm still not eating it.
There's still, see, that's, it's even worse. At least candy corn just says candy corn. You know what to expect.
That's true.
The unicorn garbage horn is trying to pretend it's something else when it's a gold plated turd.
Yeah, exactly. Like if I'm eating a unicorn horn, one, I expect it to taste amazing.
Right.
Two, I expect like instant erection because unicorn horn.
Right.
I assume it's an aphrodisiac.
Right. That's why I make soup out of them, you know?
Right. Exactly. Yeah. I mean, geez.
Yeah.
I mean, what have we been doing? Murdering all these rhinos and there's always unicorns out there.
Yeah, exactly. Wait a minute.
I mean, I could buy bags of horns. Jesus.
Right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Way cheaper, too. They're only like $3.
Chinese men.
Yeah.
What? Crazy. Imagine the markup.
Yeah.
This will get you a dick hard, son.
You know, part of me would love to see if we can market that and make it work. Because I almost bet somebody would, you know, be all for it. Especially if the price is right.
Horns. Mm-hmm. I'm Googling it now.
So we'll get a retired baseball player to promote it.
Mm-hmm.
You know, yeah, like Frank exactly. Thomas is promoting whatever it is, eugenics or whatever they call that. Nugenics, right. I think it is. Yeah. So yeah, we'll do that, and then clearly that'll be it. Boom.
That'll be it.
It'll exactly. sell millions of bottles.
Wow, I gotta say, someone. Oh, geez, Brax, what are you doing? They also have Brax a unicorn, or not unicorn? They have dragon teeth.
Same thing,
which
though, right?
Is still candy corn.
Right? They're trying. I will give them this. I'll give them credit for trying to figure out a better way to, you know, to sell
the slinger garbage.
Yeah. Yes.
Yeah. Yeah. I mean, it does say for in the corner of the bag here.
Yeah.
For the unicorn horn, that it's 5 fruity flavors, so they might taste better. Than
okay.
Candy corn.
Okay. There's at least an option for that then. Yeah.
And the dragon's teeth is strawberry chocolate.
I have a feeling dragon's teeth don't taste like strawberry chocolate.
No, it's going to be like, we're emulating the taste of a fresh dipped strawberry, and you eat it, and you're like, this tastes like my chemistry set.
Delicious.
It's that like shitty wax chocolate that you get at Dollar General. Mm. Shout out Dollar General.
Wait, didn't you already shot them out? Jesus.
Trying to get us a new sponsor, bro.
Shout them out. Boy, what a terrible
slip. I want to get some of that sweet, sweet, cheap Chinese podcast equipment.
I'd take it.
I'd take it, too.
Dude, look, if you know, pro wrestler Rusev and his wife Lana can do Dollar General commercials, I'm in.
What?
Yeah.
I mean, I'm not angry at it, but.
Yeah, they are, though. 50. I haven't even seen a Dollar General commercial in God knows how long.
I didn't even know they had the funding for commercials.
Well, you bought $11 worth of stuff. I mean, that like tripled their annual revenue.
That's true.
No, I'm kidding. That, you know, it's really weird though. Like there's been over the last few months, it seems like in this area anyway, that there's been a bunch of Dollar General stores that have been robbed. They must be an easy target or they must be seen as an easy target.
Yeah, that's craziness.
Because I've noticed there's been like three or four and like, you know, people getting shot at and whatever. I don't know. I'm sure the company is like, you know, we like press, but maybe not for this reason.
Hey, people, stop robbing us. Yeah. We're the dollar store.
Yeah. They're like, maybe, you know, like, hey, let's go with this. You know, we heard Tony spent $11 there the other day. Let's put that on the Twitter.
Yeah, dude's clearly bawling.
Right. They get out their speak and spell and see if they can, you know, put it on Twitter through that. Nah, I'm kidding. They're clearly making money because they keep building new stores. So,
yeah, I know. Well, you know, I mean, I'm not going to lie. I'm not mad at the dollar store.
No, there's like two within 5 minutes of where I live.
Right.
You know, which is weird.
But it is weird.
One's in Ohio, one's in Michigan. So, yeah. That's probably why.
No, when you gotta get your cheap stuff, mm-hmm. I get it.
Well, I mean, they saved your ass for Spooky Room or whatever.
Oh, boy, did they.
Yeah.
I tell you what, I was actually kind of impressed at the shit they had there.
Right?
I was like, what? Spooky Skeleton Garland for a dollar?
Now you have a Spooky Skeleton scarf.
Exactly. What? Two different colors of spooky cloth? I'm in.
You made yourself a nice sash.
Exactly.
Yeah.
Made myself a spooky loincloth.
So any loincloth.
Yes. Exactly.
Yeah. Oh man. So aside from Halloween, how has your week been?
You know. It's been a week, I guess. I did make mead.
Yeah.
That was pretty cool.
Yeah.
Yeah, my buddy Steve and I, shout out Steve, he listens to the show.
Woo, Steve!
Yep, exactly. We made some, I can't remember what it's called. It's called like a cider, I think he said.
Okay.
It's basically like a cider mead.
Oh, okay.
So, you know, we boiled up some apple cider and threw some honey in it and got some yeast going and threw in some spices. And he texted me today like, hey, we got to check the gravity and do a taste test, but it smells amazing. I mean, the original readings we were getting is, if it all works out the way we're thinking, it's probably going to be like a 14%er.
Ooh. I like that you started out low, you know?
Yeah.
Yeah. You know, reasonable, you know?
Exactly. Dude, you know, I mean, you've met Steve.
Yeah.
You know me. We're either going to strike out or hit a home run.
Listen, if nothing else, my strategy for how many years generally has been look at the menu and get the highest ABR on there.
Yeah, exactly. Go home.
It just goes, you know, it's just conveniently worked out that way.
Right.
Because a lot of the beers I like this time of year especially, the beers I, you know, the Scotch ales tend to be heavy.
Heavy.
Yeah.
Hey. But yeah, so yeah, should be good. It's one of those things that he was saying at the end when it's all said and done, if we taste and it's too boozy because it's whatever it is, we can actually add stuff to it to kind of cut it a little bit. And like, all right, well, you know, he knows the shit.
Yeah, fair enough.
So yeah, it was a fun experience, though, a nice learning experience. We're going to do more in the future.
That's cool. Yeah.
Yeah, I was and he did tell me too. He's like, anytime you want to brew and, you know, just let me know, you can come get my equipment. I'm like, oh shit, okay.
Sweet. Can you also get cool. The beer brewing stuff?
What?
Never mind.
Oh, yeah. Oh. God damn it, Brian. I mean, that's part of the fee is get his equipment first. I mean,
that's fair. No free rides. Yeah.
No free rides, yeah. Exactly.
I understand. Ask or ask stuff. Or cash. Yeah.
Thank you. Yeah. Jesus. I can't think. I do have very, very exciting news I got today.
Okay.
It's, like one of those proud papa moments and stuff.
Okay.
Logan got accepted to Michigan Tech.
Did he? That's the school he was really wanting to get into, right? That's the
school he was really wanting to get into.
Awesome.
All the way up there in the Great
Way. Right, right. They felt sorry for him because of the gimmick on his mouth, right?
Yeah, maybe they're like, man, do we really have to? Well, maybe they're like, oh, let's accept the handicapped boy.
A swollen face. Yeah. Old horse face, because you said he was having
exactly. Yeah, anyway. Yeah, for sure. Yeah.
No, that's really awesome, though. Yeah.
So that's pretty awesome.
Yeah. Did he get a full ride scholarship?
You know,
If not, you should tell him he's a huge disappointment.
Yeah, I should. Well, he texted me when I was at work today. He's like, hey, when you get off work, call me. I'm like, oh, all right. I'm expecting some, you know, something wrong. He's like, oh, I just wanted you to know I got accepted by, and then the phone broke out.
Perfect.
And then it came back in, like, it was a silence. I'm like, eh? Yeah, I heard you got accepted. What? And he told me, he's like, oh, that's awesome. And he's like, well, you know, I'll, cause he's going to be gone all weekend hanging out at his grandpa and grandpa's house cause his cousin's there.
Yeah.
I don't know if you can hear that. We don't have Fury Road this time, but there's a train going by so close. Can you hear it?
Only if you, like, not when you're talking. Yeah.
Train. Anyway. So he, you know, I text Jeannie and I'm like, hey, I'm so, you know, so proud of Logan. That's awesome. She's like, yeah, he was going to, you know, I told him to text you to call him because he was just going to tell you Sunday. Really? Really?
It's not that big a deal. What difference does it make, right?
Yeah. So he's going to go over the details to her thing Sunday when he's back home.
Right.
But, I mean, it's pretty awesome.
Yeah, that is really cool.
It also was one of those things I'm like, fuck, I'm old.
Yeah.
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 Going to college and shit.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Yep.
Bizarro world, man.
Yep. Yep. And yeah, like you said, moving to almost the Great White North.
So I know.
Pretty close.
Pretty damn close.
Mm-hmm.
But yeah, I mean, you know, it's just been, you know, work and adjusting to life.
Right, guys. Right. Sure.
Yeah, exactly. No, still no luck in the therapy game.
Awesome.
That's on me though, because I haven't really, honestly, really searched this week. It's been too nutty of a week.
Mm.
But yeah, it's been a week, Brian.
All right. Well, that's. Yeah. I guess it's good because if it had only been half a week, that would have been kind of weird.
That's true, right?
Yep.
How about yourself, man?
What do I have? Went to trivia on Tuesday. Stank on ice.
Like, sorry, I didn't offer my intellectual prowess.
Dude, so bad. There were a lot less teams this time, and I'm pretty sure we were close to the bottom.
Really?
That's
a bummer.
It was a bad night. Yeah.
Holy shit.
Yeah. There were quite a few times where, like, we second guessed and went with the second answer. And the first answer was the right answer. You know how it is. It happens
every time.
Yep. So, yeah, just wasn't our night. So, whatever. Right. Still good fun, but, you know, just unfortunately, no fabulous cash prizes. But I had tacos.
Well, I mean, that's half the battle.
Right.
Is having tacos.
And free fries. So.
I did see your check-in.
Right.
Like, good
job,
Ryan.
I was like, look, if they're going to give me free fries, I'm going to take free fries.
I don't blame him, right? Man. Free fries is free fries.
Mm-hmm, mm-hmm. So, yeah, it was, you know, there was that. And I started, like, I sent a message to, because I talked on here, didn't I, about how my plan is to file bankruptcy and whatnot?
Yes.
Yeah.
Yeah.
So I sent an email to a lawyer locally that, you know, looks like, it's weird. I looked up local bankruptcy attorneys, right?
Right.
There's like five or six that came up. So I went to looked at each one's website. The first one that came up, the only thing they have linked is a Facebook page and it hasn't been updated since like 2014. So really? I'm like, I think they're out of business because.
Yes. Seems like it, doesn't
there
it?
Is nothing on them on the internet. Like, there's no website. And it's like, I can't imagine you wouldn't have a website. Unless right. You're, like, super old school, you know? So I was like, well.
I guess you never know.
Yeah. But I was like, eh, you know? So I crossed them off the list.
Right.
It's like, look, if all you're going to do is Facebook, I can't trust you.
I mean, that's accurate.
Right? Yeah. You gotta have Tinder, baby. Yeah.
If they're on like Friendster, I'd be more interested.
Right. You hit your attorney up. They hit you up on LinkedIn or something.
Yeah, exactly. Like, what's your aim? What?
Uh-huh. My aim is to declare bankruptcy. Terrible. Terrible.
Yeah, exactly. That's hilarious, though.
So the next couple I look at, like, one of them's more in, like, Monroe, but they have another office that's close, but it's by appointment only. And it's like, I don't want to have to deal with that. I want a lawyer's office that I don't have to make, you know, don't have to go to Monroe, don't have to schedule randomly, you know, because like when I did before, I had to sign papers a few times. And even though that was inconvenient having to go downtown, you know, but still, it was go in, sign papers, and done. You know, it was, I didn't have to worry about making appointments or whatever, you know.
Right.
So I was like, eh, you know. Oddly enough, though, the guy who is the, I don't know, owner, head lawyer, whatever, is someone that graduated same year I did it, you know, like in my class. I don't know, like I wasn't friends with him, but I know who he is, you know.
Oh, right.
Which is unfortunate, you know, like, I don't know if I knew who he was. No, I'm kidding.
Like, hey, buddy, remember me?
You know, it's funny. I'm one of those people that people in high school tend to go like, oh, yeah, I remember your name.
Right.
Like, they couldn't tell you anything else about me, but they remember my name somehow, which I don't know how.
Which is always weird, isn't it?
Yeah. But then I found this other one that's like, sorry, folks, for being super local here, but it's on Central.
All right.
And oddly enough, guy graduated from the same high school we did. And not someone I know, though, so I don't know what year it was. Could be the same year. But his website had a thing where it broke down every step of the process. It had how-to. It had things you could download to help. And I'm looking at it, and I'm like, whoever did this website for this guy did a really good job on this. This is super informative.
Which is nice.
And this feels like someone who knows what the hell they're doing. You know, it feels like someone who's been there before, you know?
Right, right.
So I was like, I think this is the one I'm going to go with. But I figured, you know, since I'm not quite at that step yet to actually do it, I'm probably going to contact a few of the ones on that list to, you know, just get prices, if nothing else.
Yeah, that's fair.
Because we certainly learned after we closed the shop and had to do that, we certainly learned that, like, that day you went with me for mine, remember how many different prices, like, came up for how much people paid? It was weird.
Yeah, I know, right?
Yeah, so, yeah. But, so hopefully that's, you know, hopefully that's moving that way, so.
That's a beautiful thing.
Yep, so that's, making me, it's feeling really good because I feel like I'm moving forward.
Right.
You know, and it's just, I felt like I've been standing in place for so long in my life. And now that I've kind of gotten my head a little more right, now it's more like I'm having a harder time tolerating staying in one place, you know?
Well, that's a good thing.
Yeah, exactly. It's like, yeah, now my brain's like, let's get shit done. And, you know, so. It feels good to actually, like,
I'm the swim upstream, motherfucker.
You ain't kidding. Kind of is, yeah. But
it's all right, though.
Yeah. That's about it for me for the week. Yeah.
Right?
No big deal. Yeah, just.
They're super duper interesting
people. Yeah, we're very Yeah, this show was more exciting before we talked about our week.
Yeah, I know, right? When we're just making up shit about hobos and whatever else we're talking about.
Right.
Fucking candy cannons.
Right.
Exactly.
I read, I got an email from the Nerdist yesterday that tells, like, everything coming to, like, Amazon, Netflix, and Hulu for the month, right?
Oh, okay. That's kind of nice.
And I kind of skimmed over it. Like, Netflix I'm not worried about because there's this other site that I generally go to each day and look what got added.
Is it Netflix?
No. There's actually, it's this other site that tells you, like, everything. It'll even tell you, like, older stuff that got added.
Oh, that's kind of cool.
Yeah, because Netflix will generally not advertise if they put stuff back in, you know?
Right, right.
But, you know, for the Hulu and Amazon Prime, it's nice because, you know, they only, like, on Hulu, the new stuff, it only shows you, like, four things, basically.
Right.
And a lot of times they put, like, the first of the month, they put way more than that in there. They put a whole bunch of new, like, movies and TV shows in. So I'm just skimming the list real quick, and I'm all of a sudden on Hulu, I get to November 9th and I see Married with Children, the complete series. And
that's awesome.
And I'm so happy because, you know how much I love that show. And now I can just watch it ad nauseum.
Yeah, I'll probably watch it too because I power like just kicked it right in the dick. I watched all the Goldbergs. Now I'm just caught up to the current stuff.
Yeah.
So it give me something else to start plowing through again, you know?
Right. Yep. And yeah. I mean, I've seen all of the episodes, but it's still, you know, it's just a show I could keep watching. So it'll be nice, especially sometimes when I'm like, I just want to throw something on, you know, background noise.
Yeah, right.
Also, for the moment, I don't need to worry about, because I've been thinking about in the past, I almost bought the complete series because like the complete series is like $26. I mean, it's not terribly expensive. Bad. Yeah.
Is that on Blu-ray?
No.
Oh, I was like, that's amazing. That's on Blu-ray.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. If it was on Blu-ray, I would have already owned it because that would be a crazy good price. Yeah.
Yeah. It's like, holy shit.
Yeah. Speaking of Blu-ray, if y'all haven't gone on and got your Batman the Animated Series on Blu-ray, yeah. It's out.
Blu-ray. It needed the money. And I don't know where it is, so I'm not going to hit it.
Oh.
Oh, there it is. Oh. There we go.
Oh, man.
Yeah.
Yeah, I saw the Batman the Animated Series just sitting there taunting me. So, I mean, it's not one of those necessity things because I already own it, but I don't own the Blu-rays. I don't really want the Blu-rays.
Yeah, I mean, that's fair.
Yeah. So, yeah. Anyway, so, yeah, for anyone interested, November 9th on Hulu, Married with Children's drops.
That's pretty cool.
Yeah. And the whole run will be available that day.
Can you believe it's November already?
Yes.
No.
No?
I can't believe it, brother.
I mean, my calendar says 11/2, so...
Fuck your calendar!
I mean...
It just seems weird to me. I can't believe how fast this year's gone by.
Yeah, October seemed to go by really fast for me. September seemed to go slow, which wasn't bad because, you know, birthday month and all, but...
Exactly.
October seemed to just, you know, like blink and it was over. It's like I was looking at the weather report today, you know, in the next 10 days, it's supposed to get down to where like our highs are in like the mid to low 40s. And I'm like, ah, jeebus. And then I'm like, hey, it's November, man. It's, you know, like get used to it. It's, you know, those 60 degree days are going to be far and few, you know.
Yeah, exactly. That ship has sailed.
Yeah, it's time to dig out the next coat up, you know.
What a bummer.
I know. I'm sad. But what can you do?
I, too, am sad.
Yeah.
Because, like you said, coat time soon.
Yeah.
I've just been doing, you know, flannels and hoodies, basically.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Sigh.
Yeah. I've been rocking my hoodie, but it's like, unless I want to wear a warmer shirt underneath the hoodie, I got to upgrade, you know. Or maybe I'll dig my vest out. I think I still have a vest.
I am a vest boy over here.
Maybe I'll put a vest over the hoodie.
Dude, we could be LOV, Legion of Vests.
Sweet.
Go fuck people up while wearing our vests.
Right, put them through pumpkin, crates of pumpkins or whatever it was we said.
Ah, it's not that season anymore.
Doesn't matter.
Turkey displays.
Listen, that's much better since they're frozen. Yeah.
Yep, exactly. Right into a pile of butterball.
Oh, man, that would be rough. I was going to say, you know, there's still pumpkins at stores and stuff. So,
oh, for sure.
Yeah. Like Kroger will have them until like February. So,
yeah, exactly. They'll try putting like hearts on them. Like, get your Valentine pumpkin. What?
They just paint the whole thing red.
Yeah.
Valentine pumpkins.
Like, this is a thing now? Like, what happened?
Like, I don't, it's pretty soft. Are you sure this is
carve a love a lantern? Like, fuck you.
Oh, my God. I love a lantern. That would be... Oh, man. You might have just stumbled on the greatest idea ever, Tony.
I know, right?
Put it out front of your house or next to the bathtub, you know?
Dude, you're round pumpkins.
Right? Every holiday gets a new pumpkin.
Every holiday gets a new jack-o'-lantern.
I can't wait till Arbor Day. That'll be fun.
Fuck, yeah. I don't even know what you celebrate on Arbor Day. I assume it's a tree.
I don't know. Whatever.
Yeah. What is Arbor Day?
I don't know.
Do you? I'm looking.
I'd probably just use some environmentally friendly marker and write "It's Arbor Day, yay" underneath it or something.
Oh, it's 2 days before my birthday. I should know what the fuck Arbor Day is, mate.
I guess.
It's a holiday in which individuals and groups are encouraged to plant trees.
Okay.
Mm.
So we plant a tree inside a pumpkin then. Got it.
Yes.
There it is. Exactly. We sell pumpkins with cutouts in the front. There's a tree inside of it.
Perfect.
Yep. And then we put I don't know, like those little tea lights or whatever, you know, that are not actually, you know, fire, but just the little ones you can twist.
LED ones.
Yeah, you just put a couple of those in there to light the tree or something at night.
Or we can, like, you know how people make those little fairy gardens and be like, oh, look, it's a little, like, tea set. Mm-hmm. There must be fairies having a party, you know?
Yes.
So we do that. We put the tree in the pumpkin, but we make it like an avatar thing. So it's like the tree of life coming out of a pumpkin.
Yes.
And then we have Marines come in and shoot it.
You got to stay on brand, right?
Stay on brand, baby.
Yep.
So the Marines are shooting it, and there's a couple aliens on the backside just tail fucking.
As one does, yeah.
As one does.
Yeah. The 4th of July pumpkins just have fireworks inside them.
They just randomly explode.
Oh, that'd be even more fun than my idea. I was just thinking you could do it on your own, but yeah, random explosion would be way more fun.
For sure. Dude, pumpkins year-round.
Yep.
I got to open up a greenhouse so I can grow pumpkins for all the years, all the days of the year.
That's right.
You know?
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
Fuck yeah. Mm-hmm. And then you just got to try to sell them.
Right? Yeah, that's the problem. And you have to, like, figure out a way to get people to want them for, you know, like the Valentine's Day ones. You got to convince people that they're romantic somehow.
Yeah, exactly.
You know, that it'd be a nice table setting while you're having a nice romantic sketty and meatballs dinner, you know?
You're like, you gift her the pumpkin, but when you open the pumpkin, it's full of seeds. It's a sign of fertility.
Like she will be later.
Yeah.
Probably not the right campaign, yeah.
Probably not the right
campaign. No, probably not, yeah.
Then you just throw the seeds upon her face and chest.
Oh, that's terrible.
Like, what? I'm sorry.
Can't I just, like, hide a ring or some jewelry in it?
No.
Fuck you. Get your own. Come up with your own pumpkin brand. Next thing you know, year-round pumpkins with jewelry in them are outselling us.
Yeah, exactly. For sure outselling.
Dominating the market. We should have seen this coming. Yeah.
Yeah, who knew? I would have thought my bukkake pumpkin idea was amazing.
Yeah, you'd think. Good Halloween pumpkin, right?
It would be.
Yeah, probably not.
It's probably terrible.
Yeah.
Probably a terrible idea.
Mm-hmm.
Although it would be funny if you had a jack-o'-lantern surrounded by other ones and the one in the middle just covered in pumpkin seeds.
That has to exist, right? Somebody has to. Sounds like
something to do next year.
Yeah. Gonna say that seems like something that would pop up on Reddit for sure.
I mean, I have never seen it.
Yeah, I haven't either, but that doesn't mean anything.
But my awful brain thought of it.
Right.
So,
oh man.
I can't be the only one who's thought of it.
Right.
Yeah.
Oh, that's terrifying.
It's terrifying.
What a mess.
That's what the one in the middle said.
Yep.
Yep.
Uh-huh.
You betcha.
All right. So I told you that I, you know, last week I was talking about listening to Mishka Shivali's audiobook, right?
Yes.
And I'm just over halfway through it now.
Okay.
And, you know, I've told you in the past that, like, I have a harder time, like, audiobooks just don't work as well for me, you know?
Right.
Part of it, I think, is because it's just some rando reading the book to me.
You're right.
Whereas, like, this one's actually him, you know, reading the book. So, you know, like I said, he can put his emphasis where he wants it to be and such, as you said.
Right.
Um, But it's still weird because I'm like, I'm, where am I? 6 or 7 hours into the thing. And, it's weird because it's kind of like listening to a Dan Carlin podcast that I, at a certain point, I'm like, oh, I gotta stop. Like, it's just, it's the one voice for so long, you know?
Oh, okay. I gotcha.
Yeah. So it's like, I still don't think audiobooks are really for me overall, but it's so weird. I've listened to so many hours of podcasts, but I think it's because there's conversation and discussion going on. And in these, it's just one person talking, you know?
Right, right.
So
I can see that.
Yeah. But not that it's going to stop me. I mean, I'm going to finish the thing, but it's, you know, cause the story, I'm digging the book, but it's, you know, yeah, like I said, would have been, you know, so when I hit that point, much like I do with Dan Carlin, I'll just throw on, you know, music or a random other podcast or something like that to listen to kind of break up that same sound, you know.
So, right. Also makes sense.
Yeah. So, yep.
Yep, 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 yep.
So what have you been watching slash listening to? Yeah.
Listening to, just been a, you know, I've been using a lot of the Discover function of my Spotify and listening to all kinds of random shit.
Right.
You know, I like, nothing really stands out per se.
Okay.
I did enjoy a new Action Bronson album. I thought that was pretty good.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't know. No, yeah, nothing stands out, to be perfectly honest.
Fair enough.
Listen to some weird shit too, though. But, yeah. What have I been watching? Man, like I said, I powered through the Goldbergs.
Who's next?
I don't... God damn it. The Goldberg is on the Goldbergs, by the way.
Oh, he had to be.
Yeah. He plays the gym teacher's brother. And it's hilarious.
Does he play like a nerd?
No. He's basically like Goldberg.
Damn it.
You'd have to watch it.
They totally should have had him be a nerd.
that would have been funny. But, yeah, I don't know. Like I said, I don't know, Brian.
Yeah. It's weird. I've been watching so much
very
wrestling.
Very useful.
Yeah, right? There's been so much wrestling lately that it's been most of what I've been watching. And then I've been grabbing random episodes. Well, not random, but newer episodes of Drunk History, which I think I'm all through this season. But then, like, last night, I was like, I have access to the FX app, which has It's Always Sunny on it. And it's like, but I usually wait, and it's like, I'll wait till the season's over. Cause I just binge that whole damn show. I'll just, you know, I'll watch all the episodes in a row, basically. And,
which you should.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But yeah, there's a couple other shows on there too. I can't remember what it is. There's a couple other shows that I was like, oh yeah, I wanted to watch this. And it's like, but you know, then I still think of like so much Netflix. I want to, like, there's so many of the Marvel shows I haven't watched and movies. It's like,
Yeah. Like I need overwhelm. To finish Iron Fist. I need to start Daredevil.
Dude, I'm not even close to that point yet. Like I haven't watched Defenders. I haven't watched Black Panther season 2. I haven't was, you know,
you say Black Panther.
Yes. I meant Luke Cage season 2.
Oh, okay.
Ugh, what a week.
What a week.
So yeah, I just been slowly moving through stuff. I wish they would calm down with so much wrestling. Cuz I feel this Fair need enough. To watch it all, you know. Like they had a women's tournament, they just added a new like UK version of NXT, which has been interesting. So I've been watching that. Plus the stuff I already watch on Monday, Tuesday, Wednesday of theirs, you know, it's like, Jesus, you know,
it sounds like quite the event.
It's a lot. And then pay-per-views and yeah, it's so much stuff, which makes sense for them, you know, keep you just dominated.
Keep by you the engaged.
Product. Yeah. Make it hard to watch anybody else's wrestling product.
I say, people watching equals money in a pocket.
Yep, yep.
Like they need more juice.
I mean, they do. It's.
I guess.
No, they do. They do not. No. All right, so here's something for you.
What's up?
Did you see they officially put out the list of 20 games coming with the classic PlayStation?
No, I did not.
I had not looked at this list either because I kind of wanted us both to just react.
Oh, okay.
So I thought it'd be a little more fun that way.
I'm ready.
Okay. Battle Arena Toshinden. Do you remember that game?
No. Is that the game where you're like a samurai and you fight $8,000 samurai and they just keep coming at you?
I feel like it is, but I don't remember. That's what I remember it being, but that doesn't mean that's what it is.
Well, let's see here.
Oh, you're looking it up. Cool.
Battle Arena Toshinden. Survey says... Yeah, I'm pretty sure that was the game. Oh, wait. No. Weapons-based fighting game by Tamsoft. Hold on.
All right.
I wish it... stupid Wikipedia not giving me screen caps.
I know, like, right?
Like, all I need is screen caps of the game, and then I'll be like, oh, it's that game.
Yeah, exactly. I know, I hate that.
Yeah. Oh, bro. This is, this is the game where it was kind of like Tekken, but you had weapons.
Oh, okay. Okay.
Yeah.
All right. So the next one up, Cool Borders 2, which I can dig. That was a fun game.
Yeah, that was a fun game, but I'm two games in, I'm kind of disappointed still.
Right. Third game, Destruction Derby. That's sick. That was a fun game.
Yeah. I would play it. I'd play that right now. I would shut the podcast off and fire it up.
Final Fantasy VII, duh, you know.
Oh, yeah.
We all saw that coming. Grand Theft Auto, which I figured would be on there. Intelligent Cube. That's a puzzle game, I think.
I don't remember Intelligent Cube.
Yeah, I don't really remember it either, but I think it was a puzzle game. If so, I never played it, because I remember looking at it going, meh.
Yeah, right?
It was probably a great game, and I was just like, eh.
I mean, if it made the top 20 games of the PlayStation Classic, oh, I did play this game. Mm-hmm. I reckon it was like you were like a little dude, and I think the board came at you.
Oh, that game. Oh, okay. Yeah, I played that. Okay.
Yeah.
So it's not the game I'm thinking of. Okay. All right. So the next one's Jumping Flash. I don't think I ever played that.
What is what games are
I love the fact that all, like everyone like all but two pretty much you've had to look up.
Yeah, I have to keep Googling. Way to go, PlayStation.
We worked in video stores when these were out. You'd think we'd know these games better.
So I do not ever remember Jumping Flash existing. It looks like a rabbit. They made Jumping Flash 2.
Okay.
It looks like a robot rabbit. I don't know.
Okay.
I know this looks great.
Yeah, well.
But it must be okay if it made the top 20.
Well, it also, you know, it's like something that I know there were people mad about this list, but it's like something people have to remember, of course, too, is that they're trying to appeal to a mass market. You know, they're not just appealing to like the quote hardcore gamers.
Now, are these all Sony Entertainment games? Is that the problem here? Well, no, because Final Fantasy was a...
Oh, that's Square Enix.
Yeah, Square, so, okay. Yeah.
And Grand Theft Auto is Rockstar.
That's true, okay. I'm trying to figure out why some of these games are just terrible.
They were exclusive, at least those two were. I think most of these were exclusives.
Hey, maybe that's what it is, PlayStation exclusive games. That would make sense.
Even still, there's a glaring omission on this. The next game I know you've heard of, Metal Gear Solid.
What? Let me Google it.
Yeah, of course that's on there, right?
Of course.
Oddworld, Abe's Odyssey. I figured that'd be on there. Rayman. Figured that would be on there.
Okay, right.
Resident Evil Director's Cut. Not the Resident Evil I thought would be on there, but I figured there'd be a Resident Evil.
Acceptable.
Yeah. Revelations, Persona. Don't remember that.
Don't remember that.
Probably should, but I don't.
Sorry. I just said, you know.
No, I want you to, because I don't remember it either, so.
Revelations Persona Survey says, yeah, I don't ever remember. It looks like a role-playing game.
Okay.
But I don't ever remember playing this game.
Yeah, there were a lot of those kind of games that came out that I just didn't play at the time.
I don't even remember seeing like the box art before.
Right. In fairness, I spent a lot of time on Final Fantasy VII. So.
Oh yeah, for sure. Just casting the Knights of the Round spell.
Right. All right. Jeez. The next one, Ridge Racer Type 4.
Okay. Fair yep. enough.
Super Puzzle Fighter 2 Turbo.
That's a thing.
Yeah. Yeah, it was like a puzzle game, like a kind of like a Tetris type game, I think. Or was that a Match 3 game? I can't remember. It was some like puzzle type game.
Super Puzzle Fighter though?
Yeah.
Was it hosted by Ryu and Ken maybe? Is that why you got that?
I think it was. Yeah, I think those characters were on it.
Okay, well then I guess I can accept it.
I don't know, you were supposed to look it up.
Oh god damn it.
Come on, man.
Super fucking stupid game too. Super Puzzle Fighter 2 Turbo.
Yeah.
Wow, there's cartoony Ryu on it. Okay. Yeah,
I thought so.
So it looks like it's a Tetris or yeah, Magic. It's hard to tell in just the screen.
Yeah, caps. I can't remember which it was. I remember but playing it was a pretty good game.
It was like a versus puzzle game, it looks like. Yeah. And then it shows dudes like Ken's here throwing a Hadouken in somebody's face.
Right. Well, you've played.
Got like a match.
You've played Puzzle Quest, right?
Oh, yeah, for sure.
It's basically, yeah. I think it was like that. I don't remember what the puzzle part of this game was, but, you know, like where you're fighting, but it's based on your moves on the board, you know?
Interesting.
The next one, Siphon Filter. I can live with that.
Oh, fuck yeah. That I used to play awesome. The shit. It's
yep.
Split jump. Speaking, headshot.
Speaking of another game I spent a lot of time on, Tekken 3.
Oh, yes.
So exactly. Much time on that game. Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six can go fuck itself, but I can see why it's on here.
Right.
I'm only mad at it because I was so bad at it.
Yeah, for sure.
I was terrible.
Game starts, take one bullet, dead.
Yeah, exactly. Twisted Metal. Of you know, that of course should be on there.
Should be Twisted Metal too, though. That was way better.
I feel like you're right on that. Yeah. Wild Arms is the last one. I think that's a role. Oh, that was a cool one, game. Wasn't it?
Yeah.
Yeah. I can live with that one. Yeah, there were a lot of people upset about what was not on that list.
I can't think of what's not on that list that should be, and you're going to say it and be like, oh, of course.
Yeah, I'm trying to find it, actually. I can't remember. I know I saw a thing where people were...
Like, how dare they?
Yeah, well, of course, people how are going to gripe, because...
Right.
You know, of course it was, you know, like Chrono Trigger and stuff like that, you know.
Right.
That's one I see in here. I'm just scrolling through the comments right now, but I don't... Tomb Raider, Gran Turismo, you know.
Oh, I mean, I guess.
Castlevania. Right. I think we talked about that one before. So, you know, there's... The thing is, no matter how many games they picked, excuse me, unless the number was, like, gigantic, you know, people were going to gripe about it, you know? It's kind of like college football's playoff, you know? If they have 8, people will complain because their team's 9th. If they're 16, they'll complain because their team's 17th. If they're 658, they'll complain because their team's 659th, you know?
Yeah, exactly.
So.
And it's like there was so many games.
Yeah.
Because the PlayStation 1 was around for so long.
Right. Also that, yeah. And like yeah. I said, you know, and people have to appreciate that. You know, like, you don't want to put too many, like, shooters on there. You don't want to put too many role-playing games or racing games. You know, you're trying to find a balance in there, too.
In my opinion, I know what the glaring omission is, because I'm going back to my days of playing PlayStation 1. Tony Hawk Pro Skater 2.
I'm with you on that. Honestly, I'd rather play that than Cool Borders myself, but...
Yeah.
I'm knocking Cool Borders. Yeah. Game. I played Cool Borders a whole bunch, too, don't get me wrong, but...
Right.
But yeah, I spent way more time playing. Actually, well, I mean, I played Tony Hawk and what was the other one? Dave Mira?
Oh, or yeah,
Matt,
right.
No, Matt Dave Hoffman, Mira's I think, wasn't
BMX
it?
BMX Orgy of Fun or whatever it's called.
Yeah, whatever the BMX game was, too. I loved yeah. playing that one, too. But that wasn't as good. The Tony Hawk Pro Skater was way better.
Yeah, and I always, when that game first came out, I was like, whoa, dude, we'll play skateboard game. And I tried it, and I'm like, this is fucking so much fun.
Right, because the first one was eh. Then that second one came out, and hells yeah. But whatever. Yeah,
nailed it.
Yeah.
Like, I don't even like skateboarding, guys. Why do I want to play it? Oh, my God. This is great.
Right?
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah, that game was cool.
Yeah.
Good soundtrack, too.
Yes, that was something else I really liked, because that's when soundtracks, I don't want to say when they mattered in the games, because they did. Like now, like when you're playing PlayStation, you can connect to your Spotify and listen to your Spotify playlist while you're playing. You know, I'm sure you that's can on the Xbox too, you know. Right. So you can kind of forego whatever the game soundtrack is, you know. But in those days, unless you just like, you know, were listening, literally listening to something else, you couldn't do that on a lot of the games, you know?
Right, right, right.
So it was cool when that was finally, or, you know, that the soundtrack was something I enjoyed, because it was different. It wasn't like, you know, crappy music I didn't like or 8-bit sounding.
Right, right, yeah.
So, yeah. Yeah.
Well, that's something.
Yeah. I mean, honestly, though, like, me looking at this list, I wouldn't buy it.
No.
I don't think there's enough on here for me to buy. I'd much rather go buy the Nintendo systems.
Right.
There's way more on those that I would rather go back and play. Because honestly, looking at this list, I want to play Final Fantasy VII, but like I said, they're doing a remastering of it. I want to try that instead.
Yeah, just wait for that.
Like, the racing games are pointless. There's so many good racing games now, you know?
It's like Demolition Derby I'd probably play again.
Yeah, that one I might play again.
Just because that was a very unique game.
Right. And that's what I'm saying. Is like, I just can't see myself playing this enough to warrant the price.
Right.
You know? Because I beat a lot of the games. Like, Metal Gear Solid, I beat it. Resident Evil, I beat it. I just don't really have a want to go back and play. I didn't beat Siphon Filter. Maybe I'd be better at Tom Clancy's Rainbow Six now.
Right. I have one of those things, too, that I love the nostalgia of these, but I have a feeling you're going to like, oh, fuck yeah, Siphon Filter. And you fire it up and you play like the first training level. And you're like, God, this game is whack now.
Yeah. Well, it's kind of like, how much do we love GoldenEye, right? And then we play Halo for a long time. Then we go back and we're like, oh, man, we haven't played GoldenEye for a while. Let's fire that up. And we're like, wow. Graphics on this just stink, you know?
Exactly. Like, I just got killed by a Minecraft character.
Right. What happened? And we have to play on the same TV.
Yeah.
You know, exactly. It's like, ugh. So that's the other thing, is there's so many of these games that there's, like, I liked Resident Evil 2 better. I think it's Resident Evil 2. Whatever one, the double disc where you could play as the guy or the girl. Yeah,
2.
Yeah.
2 was far superior to 1.
In my opinion, yeah. Metal Gear Solid, you know. Was 2 on the PlayStation, though, or was that on the PlayStation 2?
Oh, no, it was on the PlayStation.
Okay, I couldn't remember.
Yeah.
But, you know.
I bought it.
Yeah. So, a lot of people think there's better Final Fantasy games, you know. It's just whatever. I just, like I said, for me, there's not enough here to buy this. I'd rather, honestly, just go to the Sony store and buy a couple of the games if they're available, you know, that I might want to play and call it good.
Or just go buy a Bluetooth controller and download an emulator.
No, we can't advocate that on here, remember?
Oh, what? I meant Steam, do it legally for Steam.
Right.
Right.
Yeah.
That's it.
Yeah. Oh, yeah, Final Fantasy Tactics is an interesting one, too. Like, people just listen ones. It's like, again, you there's already Final Fantasy II, Wild Arms, and wasn't there another? You know, you got to be careful how many. I know that's a different kind of game, but, you know, you still got to be careful you're not doing too many of the same type of game. Because otherwise, somebody who's not a fan of role-playing games will go, oh, wow, why would I want this?
Right.
Now, what they could do is offer.
Just put.
Different configurations.
Yeah, or even like, you know, give it a memory card slot.
I wish.
If you're like, oh, here's 10 games you can add onto it now.
Well, or, you know, I was reading somebody mentioned this in, I think it was on Reddit I was reading it, that they could put out, like you were saying, like cards, like have a couple of slots on the thing, or at least one. And, you know, like SD cards, of course, or whatever you're using. And have it to where there's X amount of games on it and just put a new one out every so often.
Yeah, exactly.
Then you could just buy the new one and you can, and then the system gains value over time because you're like, oh, now I can play all of these games, even though I've had to spend more money, but you know, you don't mind it as much.
Right.
Because that's the same as any console. You know, by itself, it's worthless, you know? But if you have a ton of games available, now you're like, oh, man, there's all these choices, you know?
Right. Yeah, exactly.
So, yeah. I don't think it's a bad list. I think I'm a little disappointed. But I think a lot of that, too, is I think it, you know, it's kind of like in wrestling when people talk about it, you start fantasy booking, you know?
Right.
And then when they don't do what you want them to do, you're like, this is terrible. You know, and I think that's
kind of the worst thing I've ever seen.
Yeah, that's what the internet does. You know, it's like this right. is the ultimate list ever. You know, and then one game's not on there, and they're like worst list ever. You know,
this is terrible.
Yeah, I mean, I'm disappointed. No Barbie Magical Ride or whatever the horse game.
I'm disappointed with no Tenchu. I want my ninja games back, where I can drop out of ceilings and slice people's necks.
Yeah. One thing that is really nice is that the systems do have, like in the stores, they do have old games you can buy, you know, right. So you can grab some of those old games and play them. They may not have everything available, but there's, you know, I don't know if Tenchu is available or not.
Bastards.
Or like on Xbox, well, both systems have it where you can get a subscription-based thing where you can play like old games.
Right.
And there's a, you know, pretty robust catalog on both of them.
Do you remember, that fighting game I had for PlayStation? I want to say it was called Bushido Blade.
Yes.
It was a sword fighting one. You like slash your arm and another arm drops.
Yeah.
That fucking game was cool. I enjoyed that game a lot.
I used to love games that did that. Like, you remember like in like No Mercy and stuff, like you, or WrestleMania 2000, whichever one it was like the more you work the leg, you know, the guy would kind of hobble a little bit or, you know, like I love games where that happened because that's how it should be, you know,
yeah, right.
Like if I'm watching UFC, you know, very few guys are taking like 1,000 leg kicks and still walking like nothing happened, you know,
it's true.
Usually that leg's all knotted up and they're dragging it a little bit.
Right. Exactly.
You know? So, yeah. So it's
craziness.
You got anything, any other stuff?
Believe it or not, no, not really.
No, it's fine. I have a couple quick things here, basically.
Beautiful.
Did you see in San Francisco, was it the Salesforce Tower? Because of a petition signed by a ton of people from change.org, they lit the tower up at the top to look like the Eye of Sauron on Halloween.
That's amazing.
It was pretty awesome. Yeah.
I did not see that.
Yeah.
I'm looking for it now.
Yeah. That was pretty cool. I like the fact that they did it. Although one of the first comments on this is from ABC News, the one I'm looking at. One of the first comments on there was like, this is cool and all, but the sight of seeing the top of a building looking like it's on fire was a little scary. And I was like, yeah, that's a good point. You know,
I mean, I guess.
Yeah. You look up at the, you know.
I mean, that's pretty cool.
Yeah.
I'm a fan of that.
Me too. I thought that was pretty cool to do for a night. You know, they always do random stuff like that for various sports teams and all this other stuff, you know. I thought it was pretty cool they do it for the Eye of Mordor. Or, Eye of Mordor. Jesus.
Eye of Sauron?
Yeah. That's why.
It'd be great if people were dressed up as, like, hobbits and shit.
Just around it.
Yeah, just happen to be there.
What would be great is if any visitors the whole day, basically, if the security guards are like, one does not simply just walk into
San Francisco.
Just be assholes all day.
Yeah, right.
Be like, ha, I get it. All right, let's move it along. We got business.
Drop it. You just drop it.
Nope. Like, laugh at my joke or you ain't getting in. Fine. Yeah.
Take it, dick.
Yeah, right? Quit being such a jerk.
Cool.
Right? Oh, man. Oh, I totally forgot when we were talking Halloween stuff. They put a Hardy Halloween special up on the WWE Network. You know?
Oh, my God.
And here's the thing. It's everything pretty much you could want it to be, except I really want it to be an hour. I feel like the story they were trying to tell in there, that they could have really done some more stuff if they had a little longer to tell it. But they hit on a bunch of stuff, you know, all the characters that you want are there, you know. Vanguard 1, and, you know, he gets a girlfriend, so there's Vanguard 1 now, and, you know, Senior Benjamin gets hooked up with some hoes by the Godfather, so, you know, finally he's not so lonely, you know. I mean, Senior Benjamin's been through a lot. He deserves some hoes.
Yeah, I just love the fact. Was it actually the Godfather?
Oh, it was the Godfather, yeah.
Okay.
The best part to me, on spoilers if you're going to watch it or whatever, but the Godfather goes into the Lake of Reincarnation, and when he comes back out, he's Papa Shango.
That's pretty great.
Because, you know, the same guy was both. So, and I was hoping for that when he was near the water, you know, because Jeff Hardy goes in and then he comes out as, I forgot the character's name, the one where he's, like, wearing the, like, jester's hat and he's all crazy acting.
Right.
But, yeah, it was, and there's a scene with Matt and Joe Frazier, which is his sparring partner, the kangaroo.
Smoking Joe Frazier?
Yeah. Nice. And he's trying to give him an invitation to the party, and the kangaroo keeps trying to, like, grab onto his shoulders.
Is this an actual kangaroo?
Yeah.
That's funny.
Yeah. Yeah, and he talks with George Washington again, you know, the giraffe.
Wow.
Yeah, it's, like I said, it's everything I wanted it to be, except I feel like they kind of cramped it together because they only had half an hour, you know?
Right.
So it felt a little abrupt to me. I feel like they could have done more, or even 45 minutes. I think they just need a little extra time to, you know, to, because the story was that someone was infiltrating the party, and they were going to try to steal, because Matt has Excalibur, and,
right,
you know, that's the source of all the Hardy power, basically, the broken power. And it turns out that the imposter ends up being, it's an imposter of Hurricane. You know, Hurricane Helms.
Is it Typhoon?
No. That would be funny. No. But at the end, though, it reveals, like, some evil person or whatever. They don't show you who it is. But then you see the Hurricane is tied up. So, you know, maybe this is the beginning of more. That, you know, I'd love to see them give them an ongoing show on the network.
That would be silly.
It you know, just once every few months or something like that, drop a new one, you know?
Right.
So, but yeah, it was something.
It sounds like something.
It was something. Well, every one of those it's weird as hell, but there's always moments in them that are really fun to watch, you know? So,
right.
Yeah. If, again, as I've said with most of the Hardy stuff, if you're a fan of the other stuff, you'll dig this.
If you're not,
then I got two words for you.
Change the three words.
Yeah. Stop watching. Yeah.
Oh, there you go. That's two words.
Yeah.
Winner.
Okay. So I have something else wrestling related here.
Okay.
Have you seen, these have been around for a while and somehow I've not seen these. Have you seen filtered wrestling promos?
No. Can't say that I have.
People are taking Snapchat filters and applying them to, like, Ric Flair wrestling promos. Like the Snapchat filter where it's like the zoom in of the mouth to where, like, the nose disappears, and using it, like, on Ric Flair speeches and stuff. And
that's kind of funny.
I can't stop laughing at them. They're ridiculous. So
it usually has a nice sort of weird voice altering thing. And
yes. Yeah. So, I'll have a link in the show notes to I'm looking at the Ric Flair one right now. Cause I don't know if you remember the one promo where he says something and he's like, with a tear in my eye. And it's just with these big eyes and the big mouth. It just,
that's so pretty good.
The one I've got sitting up here to watch is the Dusty Rhodes, Hard Times one. I can't wait to watch that one. So
Hard Times.
Yep. So unfortunately, it's like, I wish there was like a YouTube place, or like I followed this account or a hashtag, I mean, on Twitter, but I can't find like one account or something that's putting them up there. The only thing I could do next would be to search maybe like Reddit. You know, maybe there's a subreddit for just filtered promos.
It would not surprise me, because there seems to be a subreddit for everything.
Right. I just want one place I can just go right to, and that's what the hashtags allowed me to do, I guess, but you know.
Your hub of filtered.
Yeah.
Yeah. Or you just start making them, man. Hey, man, just make them, man.
Oh, jeez. All right, I got to stop looking at these. I'm going to keep laughing. Just looking at The Rock, which is funny as hell. So, anyways, yeah, that's, like I said, I'll have a link to the hashtag in there, or you can just look hashtag filtered wrestling promos if you don't feel like looking through the show notes.
Get your make them look through
the show notes. Yeah, look through the show notes.
It's not available anywhere else. Exclusively at saltylanguage.com.
Exclusively in the notes. Yeah. That's what I got. Story wise. I have a couple shut up and take my monies though.
Oh shit. I'll turn it up a wee bit.
Shut up and take my money.
And, I mean, you and I have already talked about these, but nobody else had to know that.
Damn, Brian.
So as usual, my shut up and take my monies are Funko Pops. And,
right.
These aren't like horribly limited ones. But they're making, pops of Queen, the band. Right. They're making three different Freddie Mercurys. And then one each of the other guys that, you know, people care less about.
Naturally.
So, and I think they did a really nice job on these. They look pretty great. Even the other guys are, like, look really good when you look at pictures of them and look at the pops. Even though, honestly, they could pretty much just put any pop in those places and most people wouldn't know who the hell. They'd be like, oh, cool, and just buy it.
Well, yeah, fair enough.
Because... Yeah. So, but either way. Anyway, so that's the first one. I'll have a link to, you know, pictures of them if anyone wants to see them. And, oh, actually, sorry, I had one more story I forgot about. Whoopsies.
How dare you, sir?
I know.
How dare you?
I know. And the last one is actually the first one I told Tony about that excited me just as much or more, which is they announced a while ago they were doing Wayne's World Pops. But they finally released what they look like. And I think they hit a home run on those.
Yeah, they're pretty great.
And then there's also going to be a Target exclusive 2-pack of them, like when they're doing, when they're playing hockey. So they're in their Chiefs. Hockey gear, which I love the fact that much like the, oh my God, I can't think of his name. Cameron from,
Ferris Bueller.
Thank you. Ferris Bueller. The pop of him has a Red Wings jersey on.
Right.
I like the fact that they went out of their way to get the actual license. They didn't just put random dumb logo or something on.
Yeah. Just like a red jersey.
Yeah. So I very much appreciate that. So, and those are pretty cool looking. I especially, my favorite part about it is, you know, just like in the movie, obviously, but Gart's glasses over the hockey mask.
Yeah, it's pretty great.
Yeah. So good. Or the goalie mask, I should say. So, yeah. So there you go. That's the shut up and take my money.
Shut up and take my money.
Yeah. Yep. Actually, you know what? I think I'm going to skip the other thing.
No. All right. So, fair enough. Save it for next week.
Forget about it. Yeah, maybe. I might just forget about it altogether.
Forget about what? I don't know what we're talking about.
Exactly. Hey. All right. So let's do a Dude Mountain update, I guess.
Oh, shit. So it means I got to go down here. I got to do this.
Dude Mountain.
Oh, dang.
All right.
Yeah.
Oh, dang, is right.
Did you pull it up or should I?
I got it right here, son.
All
right,
cool.
I
was doing else, or other things.
So down here, down the bottoms of the Dude Mountains.
Yeah.
We got, coming in dead last, we got Gaga James 2 swimming in the broth, the frothy brine.
I actually think from looking at things, it looks like they may have drowned in the brine.
I think so. I don't know if they've been making pics.
I'm not seeing signs of life. Yeah.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah.
So if they're not, I guess we'll go top, bottom four then.
Yeah.
Since I think we have a floater.
We got a floater. Yeah, sorry. Got a
floater. So once again, steaming in the port, you have the USS Mangrovey.
Nice.
Followed by Dr. Feelgood, mm-hmm. And then Neil Tom Jovi, who, it's unusual. He was on top of the pack last year.
I know.
This year, he's just being lathered in the drippings from the top of the mountain.
Yeah. Yeah.
Speaking of the top of the mountain.
Yeah.
Tied for third. We got the underdogs and Barry L. McCockiner.
Right.
Coming in number two, beside a geek. And coming in the number one top spot of Dude Mountain is the Madden 2016 pick.
Coming in with another consistent week.
That is hilarious.
I'll tell you what, looking at this week's picks, I'll be shocked if it gets nine this week. It went with a lot of picks that are type picks, but there's been quite a few where I've thought that before and it's nailed them, so we'll see.
You know, I'm already started simming games and just going to Vegas.
Right.
Jesus. It's silly. It's just silly.
Like I said, all it keeps proving to me is I'm glad I don't bet on football. You know?
Yeah, really.
Yeah. Or at least against the spread, you know.
Right. It's so bizarre.
Yeah. Pretty awesome. I'm digging. Yeah.
So I guess that's your Dude Mountain update there, kids and kidettes.
Yep.
Mountain. There you go.
Man, that was terrifying.
I know. I'm scared. I'm
pretty sure I swallowed myself.
I did that hours ago.
Damn it, Tony. You could have went and cleaned up. I mean,
nah.
Right.
Bad boy, sit in my filth.
I kind of want that as a sound drop. Cut that out. I'm a bad boy, sit in my filth. Sounds like a song lyric.
I don't know, right? Doesn't it?
Right.
It's because it is.
Oh yeah. Right.
Yeah.
All right. What you got?
For what?
Oh, was there any on Facebook? That's what I was meaning.
Oh, no. No one answered a goddamn Q to Dubs on Facebook, man.
Concern it? That's like two or three weeks in a row. Is it not posting on Facebook?
It might not be.
We're going to have to look into this. We're going to have to get our trained chimps on the job here.
Yeah, because I got nothing.
I got a feeling they're just too worried about throwing shit around and they're not doing their jobs.
I mean, it's accurate.
Yeah. I mean, we should have known. That's what we get for hiring chimps and, you know, allowing them access to feces. Yeah. All right. Where is it? There we go. Jeez, I didn't realize I had three Twitter tabs open. All right. So the question last week was, if you were God, what would you do to mess with humans in subtle ways? On Twitter, Philip says, if I were God, I would have their shoelaces become untied at an abnormally high rate and not let Velcro or bungee shoelaces be a thing.
That's hilarious.
So mean, dude.
So mean.
I think he's still got some anger from his years working the shoe stores, you know?
I mean, I would too.
Yeah. I mean, he did work at, you know, Gary's for a long time. That's a Mary with Children joke for the kids who don't get it.
Gary's?
Yeah. That's where Al worked.
Fair enough.
And then found out Gary was a woman. Enough of that. Yeah, I'm looking to see if I got any others on Twitter. I think his was the only one, unless I missed some.
Right.
Which makes me so sad. Oh, nope.
So sad.
Wow. Heno sent in a very detailed one. And if you're easily squeamish, you may want to, you know, forward a few seconds or so here. He says, return from Vegas with open herpes sores on your junk. Doc sees skin tags. You see green gonorrhea dripping from your pud. Doc says it's just a bladder infection. Freaking crabs crawling through your Sherwood pube forest. Doc laughs. It's dandruff. Boy, that would really fuck with people.
That's slightly disturbing.
Yeah. Yep.
I almost don't want to finish my beer, but I'm going to. I'm just saying.
Yep. Here's another one from at Beside a Geek, pod. Sorry. Give their whole title there. It says, I'd give people free will and then a bunch of rules taking all the fun out of it.
That's pretty funny.
Well,
that's
played.
Pretty damn funny.
Well played. Okay, I think that's the last one. Yep, because that goes into last week. So, then in the emails is, I got, where'd it go? Oh, there it is, from Ashley. She says she has two. She said, one, I would provide absolute undeniable proof that I as God do exist, but then do absolutely nothing to help anyone. No answered prayers, no miracles. More likely me just showing up and pointing and laughing every time you trip or drop something on your foot. And two, anytime someone pointlessly thanked me for winning the big game or some stupid award, I'd be like, fuck off, I didn't do shit.
That's pretty funny.
Yeah. I like her. That. And then she mentioned just like, you know, show up at an award show and just like snatch the trophy and take off.
Right. Cause God.
Right. I couldn't do this without God. I'm like, cool. Just you take the trophy. Oh. So that is what I got for this week.
Update. Yeah. The stupid if this, then that applet was turned off. Somehow.
Well, that's stinky poopy. So, yeah, okay.
I think it's because, like, everything that, you know, every once in a while Facebook's like, you must reattach all the things you have connected to Facebook.
Yeah.
I don't know why they do that, because it sucks, I guess.
Because they're jerks.
Yeah, so that's why we haven't got any the past 2 weeks.
Mm-hmm. That would explain it. Okay. Thanks, Facebook.
Right.
They get stinky poopy faces of the week award.
Indeed.
Heno sent me, last week, for the state slogans, the honest state slogans, or the week before, whatever it was, there were some in our chat that I, didn't see, but he had copied them down so we could have them. He said, from our pal Big Dev, Michigan, the UP didn't make up for Toledo, which I like a lot. Michigan, living here is a lot like wearing a wet wool mitten. Accurate as fuck.
Very accurate.
Michigan, you're more likely to die of lead poisoning in Flint now than Detroit.
That's also good.
Also accurate.
Yeah.
Hans Gruber, our friend Garrett, says, Washington, it's not all Seattle. It's pretty much like my Michigan, it's not all Detroit concept, you know? Which makes sense. When people think of Washington, I think they do automatically think of Seattle, mainly because they probably can't name another city.
Right.
Jared says, California, you can toast marshmallows in 90% of the state. those are strong.
Those are very strong.
Good strong answers. All right. So, I guess I should open up the document so we can choose this week's, unless you have something else.
No, but I mean, we got to go with.
I like what you got. Good job.
All right. Boom. All
right. I believe there's 24. I think there was 25 last week. Yep. 1 through 24, sir.
Three,
huh? All right. What is your favorite free activity and why?
Free activity and why?
Yeah.
Oh, my. I mean, the possibilities are endless, really.
Yeah, right?
You know?
Yeah.
And sometimes I like just taking a nice walk because it's nice.
Right.
You know, sometimes I like taking that fresh morning dump because it's nice. There's so many.
Sometimes you do both at the same time.
Sometimes. Yeah. No, wait. I'm assuming they mean something that actually, like, an activity that you actually go out and do that's free, though.
Yeah, let's put that on it, because otherwise, I mean, really, the real answer for most of us should be, like, the sex.
Yes,
I exactly. I mean, because what's topping that?
The boning.
Anyway, but yeah.
So I guess my
although in fairness, you could go out of your house to do that. I'm not saying you can't. But
well, yeah. I mean, this is accurate,
right?
I would say I like going to a bar and they just have like live music going,
just enjoying the the music.
Yeah, enjoying the jams, because sometimes it's really good, sometimes it's bad, which makes it good.
Right. It's like going to karaoke.
I generally usually enjoy the musics that are live, and especially when there's no cover being charged.
True.
Yeah.
That does help.
Yeah.
Sweet.
Oh, yeah. There you go.
What is mine? It's a really good question. I don't know, because I really don't go do anything. It's probably just, you know, I mean, realistically, trivia itself is free. I enjoy going and doing that, even though I always do get something. There have been a couple times where I haven't bought anything. So, you know, that would probably be my favorite thing at the moment. But if it's something where, like, every time I do it, I don't spend any money, it would be, I don't know. It's weird. I really like going out looking for, like, the Funko Pops and stuff. Like, I just like looking at other toys and collectibles.
Right.
You know, it was like my favorite part of when we worked at a comic shop or had ours was, you know, one of my favorite parts was, you know, going through the previews catalog every month and just seeing all the cool stuff that was coming out. You know?
Oh, yeah, for sure. I could see that.
Yeah, and I love when you can go into those comic shops that are like the bigger ones where they can afford to stock a bunch of that stuff, you know, and you get to see it all, you know, in person rather than just on the paper, you know? So, you know, it's like it's window shopping. And, yeah, I mean, I could spend money, but most of the time I don't have any money to spend, so I'm window shopping 99% of the time probably. But, like, the Pops, I just like seeing them. Like, I'm a big fan of just seeing, you know, looking at them and seeing the jobs they did on them and stuff. So,
right.
Take your pick. One of those two. I think that's what I'm going to go with. Or, I mean, I guess, I mean, I went and saw wrestling last time for free, so, I mean.
I mean, there's nothing wrong with that.
Yeah, that's not a regular thing, though. I wish. But, yeah. So, yeah, I'll go with that.
Fair enough.
Yep.
Fair enough. So I guess, you know, what sort of free activity that you can't do at home? Is that what we're saying?
Yeah, I think so. You know.
All right. So, yeah, you know, what we just said and stuff.
Show me what you got.
Boo. Yeah.
Yep. Perfect. All right. Yeah, I think that's... That's it, right? I don't have any other. Just going over the notes again. I've had this habit the last few weeks of missing Cue the W things sent to me. So,
right.
I'm trying to skim it one last time. Nope. I think that's it. So I guess before we get into the final stuff, I'll, you know, throw the thing out there again that, if you'd like to help the show out and or get some sort of, you know, drawed thing from, me and or Tony or whatever. You know, we're, you know, taking donations or contributions, however you want to word that, over at our Patreon, which is at Salty Language, or, well, it's on Salty, it's on our website, but it's at patreon.com/saltylanguage.
Correct.
Or go to our website and there's a link. anything over $5 can get you something, you know, like the more, you know, we'd appreciate it the more you give, especially if you're going to ask for something that's, you know, detailed elaborate. Or whatever. Yeah.
Yeah.
Just, you know, just for us to have some fun, maybe raise a little cash to help keep the lights on the podcast and whatnot.
I mean, not what's for, you know, you're asking for us to smash paint cans between our ass cheeks.
Right. No, that costs way more.
Like, way more.
Dude, my appearance fees are not cheap.
Yeah, for sure, right? I've been to a couple of your gallery openings.
Right. Only the elite get to go, so...
Exactly.
I don't know how you got in, but you're just at the window looking in. Somebody comes out with a broom. Go and get swatting at you with the broom.
Exactly.
They shine a light on you that your eyes just glow and you hiss because raccoon. Yeah.
Raccoon.
Seems accurate. Yeah, right? Yep. So anyway, yeah, if you'd like to do that again, you know, just click on the link on our website, which is saltylanguage.com, where you can find everything else you need from us, you know, past episodes, the enthusiast episodes. You can see the networks we're part of, such as the Tangent Bound Network and...
Shit, I almost hit the wrong one.
Danger! Watch your back! Danger! Entertainment. Were you going to hit the Yeah Boy one again?
Yeah, it's right above.
Okay.
It's like right above it.
No, it's acceptable if you hit that one because you hit it once. So at least if that's the go-to gag, you know.
Yeah,
for sure. Yeah. We'll just have to tell Mark he's got to change the name of the network to the Yeah Boy Network.
Yeah, exactly. Or like Flava Flav Podcast Incorporated or something.
That seems like that would get him sued. But
probably.
Yeah Boy so might too. I don't know. Flavor Flav may have a copyright on that.
He might.
It wouldn't shock me. Or, I don't know, he's probably got a Podcast One podcast. They probably already got it trademarked. So.
Yeah, like Yeah Boy Cast.
Yeah.
Yeah Cast.
Yeah Boy Cast. That just sounds so awkward.
Yeah, awkward and dumb because yeah. It is.
Yeah, fair point.
Fair point.
If you're going to be doing any shopping on Amazon, please swing by our website first. Click the Amazon banner. It'll take you to Amazon. Then you can just shop away as normal. And they toss us a few breadcrumbs and, you know, pat us on the head and say good boys. So
naturally.
Yeah. And that's always our goal, just to be the goodest boys.
The bestest and goodest of boys.
Yep.
It's true.
You know, especially now with Halloween over, everyone's got to be geared for Christmas, right? Ugh.
Oh, yeah.
Whatever.
Bastards.
I know, right?
Still trying to get my pilgrim costume out of the closet now.
Right? Seriously.
Jesus.
You got to keep worrying about the skeleton first.
I know, right?
You got to get crazy. All spooky in there.
So spooky.
Spooky. What was I going to say? I forgot. Oh, if you'd like to submit a Q of the W question to us or, you know, hit us up for any reason, you can do so via email at saltylanguage@gmail.com, on Twitter at salty_language. You can find me at Stunami.
You can find me at Monotony. Or you're better off probably reaching me on Snapchat, salty_language.
More like Monot on Twitter.
Yeah, exactly. But not even looking at my notifications.
Yeah. You can find me on, I don't remember which you just said, Snapchat or Instagram. Snapchat, you can find me at Ninjitsu if you'd like to.
There you go. There you go.
Word. And, yeah, I think that's mostly, we'd appreciate it if you would rate, review, and subscribe. If you, you know, could take the time, we would greatly appreciate it. If you haven't already, you know, just remember that 5-star ball wash, folks.
5-star ball wash.
It's what keeps us going.
Rate, review, share.
Yep.
Wash them balls.
Yeah, I was looking the other day. It's been a while since we got some reviews, man.
How dare you?
I know. Yeah, so if you haven't reviewed, you know, like I said, please do so. If not, you know, no pressure. Tony, put some pressure on.
Dude, we need it. How's that?
That'll work, I'm sure.
Perfect.
So I think that's everything. If not, saltylanguage.com has everything you could.
Yeah, just go to our website and figure it out, stupid.
Well, there's that, I guess. So there you go. So I guess until next week, have a beer, you'll be fine.
Stay super salty.
Oh, the saltiest. And
saltiest.
Don't forget,
and spooky.
Don't forget to get your Valentine, or well, no, your Thanksgiving pumpkin.
Yeah, that's right.
You know, because I don't know what Thanksgiving pumpkin is.
Drop your pants, put a turkey neck on it.
All right, that's way better than mine. I was going to say you draw one of those lame ass hand turkeys on it, but yours is way better.
Put a hand turkey on it, and it's like the brotherhood we know
Yeah.
situation.
Right, you're right.
Yeah.
There you go. Nothing says I love you at Thanksgiving to your family like dropping turkey neck.
Yeah, for sure.
So with that, we'll talk to you next time.